In this video, I'm going to explain some of the editing tools in Mesh command. So I will first start with splitting the face of mesh and then extruding it. For that, I will create a simple mesh primitive. So let's click here this flyout and choose box. Here you have plane geometry. Now when you hover your cursor, you will notice that we have 9 number of faces, 3 faces in each row, which is total of 9 faces. So in order to refine a mesh, or in order to have a better control over the faces of mesh, we may need to split the existing faces into multiple parts. For that, we can use this split face command. Now for that, let's select split face tool and go to the mesh. Choose the face you want to split. Suppose if I want to split the face over the center, then all you need to do is click that face and now specify the parting line. So let's click this midpoint of this, then this midpoint. As you can see, the face has been split into two parts. You can manipulate these faces separately. So now let's try to extrude one of the divided face. For that, go to filter and select face, then choose extrude face command from this panel, then select the face and press enter. Now when you move your cursor, you will notice that only selected face is extruded here. Now even after adding smoothness to this geometry, we can extrude these faces. For that, let's apply smooth more command, select it, then choose the object and press enter. As you can see here, after applying smoothing tool, the face retains its shape. Now let's extrude, click tool, choose the face and press enter. In this way, you can extrude splitted faces separately. And here we have it. In case if you want to unite or match the faces back to original shape, then you can choose the second option, which is match face, then select the face and press enter. As you can see, the faces is matched into one unit face. When you click it, it will be selected as single face. Let's see other editing commands. For this, we will create a normal solid primitive box, and then I will add a cylinder to it on one of its edge. And now I will join both of these solids into single geometry. For that, select union, then choose both object and press enter. As you can see here, we have one unit object. Now before applying mesh modification tools, we need to convert these objects into mesh. For that, select this smooth tool and choose the object, then press enter. Now this warning message will pop up and it will prompt you to specify whether you want to convert this object into mesh or not. Obviously, we want to convert it into mesh. Click on it so we have it, a completely scrambled mesh object. Now if you want to decrease the smoothness which has been added to this geometry, then click this smoothness and select object, press enter. In this way, you can convert and edit 3D object with the help of mesh tools. Now if you want to extrude part of this geometry or face, in this case you can do that by simply clicking extrude command and select the face, then press enter. It is clear that we can apply all these commands after converting a normal solid primitive into mesh. So this was all about mesh and mesh primitive in AutoCAD.